my friends, YouTubers, crocheters, I have, I would like to do another part to finish up this sloth or monkey, whatever you want to call it. It's a sloth to me, but whatever you decide. Anyway, I went ahead and did the body. I didn't think it was something you'd be real thrilled watching me make, as long as the arms and legs took yesterday. So I've already made the body. I'm gonna stuff it, close it up, and then we can add the face today. So let me move you down a little bit and get you started and seeing what I'm doing. Things out of the way. Okay. I got the faces. I got the little feet and the arms, which are the longer ones. Body is done. So I'll go ahead and stuff it. And then we'll close it up. Go ahead and take this off. My little marker, homemade marker. So funny. Stuff it as full or as little as you want. Okay. So after we do that, we go ahead and close off. I've got, you can either use your crochet hook or your needle. Make sure I've got the right hook here. So, let me see. Take this off. Go ahead and go ahead and thread it through. I think I'll close it this way. Might give it a smoother look, and then I can go ahead and add the face to it. Sometimes these things are stubborn. There we go. Not too bad. Okay. First, I'll go ahead and knot that. And if I have to, I'll take it and put it underneath if it causes a problem for me. So I think it will look just fine this way. I'm just doing back and forth, try to make it and then you'll place the face on there. If you want to cover this or put it up against it. Let's see what the directions say. Choose your preference placement position and stitch the face to the body. So let me see. This face. Or this face. I think that one's nice. So I think I'm going to end this and then add the white to it. Maybe the white would be better. I'm not real sure if the white outlining would be better or the brown. Let me try the brown first. I think it might, I don't think it matters really. So what I'm gonna do is find a spot. Maybe I'll change that. I think I'm imagining that the white would probably be better. So I'll change that to white. I think I'll be a little more pleased with that. Go. Yeah. And then I'll weave that in. So let me clip this little piece. I'm going to leave a tail for now. Just pulled it all the way through. Let me see if I can do a deep. They're not in there real deep. Might be okay. There we go. Probably go around this a second time. I'm just kind of basting it. I don't want to tear anything. Go. So I'm going to do a whip stitch around in some areas. Gotta hold the face in place so it doesn't move. Go. Hope you can see this. Okay, so I am going to finish this off. Bury it deep. Like that. These can be buried. The eye is going to have to be fixed. Let's do some claws. My clues. Not this. Sorry, that's my clock. Gone. This is a marker that I had. Okay, these are the arms. These are going to be the claws. And do this twice. Make it kind of thick. You don't have to do twice, but I'm giving it a shot to see if that looks better so that they're more defined, you can see them better. How does that look? Okay, so I'm going to put a little knot and bring it on through someplace. That's one. And some more yarn. Let's do the next one, and I'll sew them on, and maybe I'll knot it in there. See how that looks. Sometimes these little tapestry needles are a little tough. I have trouble going through things. So I'm gonna use my crochet hook and pull that through. Find a good area to pull it in. Probably could have doubled this up and not have to do this, string them through twice, but I just wasn't sure. There we go. There we go. let's see, go up here, make a knot, pull this one through. Excuse me, and then I will cut this off and pull it through with my crochet hook. Find a good spot in between rows or rounds and pull it on in. So these are done. These are the next ones. Let's get some of this out of the way. In like we did before. Just play with it and see what's best for you, how you want to do this, if you want to double up the thread, single. I think I'm going to do single on this. Let's see what they look like. Okay, let's put it back through. Find a spot up here to come through. There's one. And we will do the last one. So tell me what you like in the comments. Do you like them single or double on the legs and the hands, or the feet and the hands? Hands are the longer ones, the arms, I should say. So and would you prefer buttons to the eyes or just the thread, the embroidery floss thread? Okay, pull this through and we'll go ahead and sew it. So these might not be long enough, but we will give it a try. So the arms are the longer ones. Find a good spot on the side. Just position where you think. So I'm going to go from the body up through both layers on this. Back down. Come back up. Make sure you reinforce the ends, because that's the, you know, you want to make sure that's down too. So I've got one down. Knot it up. Bury it in the stuffing or the batting. Pull enough through like that. And that will get buried. Go in there and wiggle the hook in there. One leg. The other one. This might not be. Let me get a whole new one so I don't have to keep unraveling. Keep using that. Get another one, I mean. This way, this is continuous. I don't have to keep threading the needle. So kind of make sure it's the same area on the other side. I'm going to go ahead and stuff this thread in there, this yarn. Make sure it looks even. Does that look good? So I will go in secure that end. I'll go around it a couple times. Okay, I think 3 is good for me. I'll go ahead and weave this in and out. Okay, this one I'm going to secure the end. Goodness. Can't be tough. These things are so cute. Are so cute. Go over and do this. Looks like the end doesn't look very tacked. Tack this end a little better. So we'll knot it so it gets buried in the batting. Okay. You got your little legs. This gets buried. Okay, then the arms. Kind of make it even on the other side. Let's knot it. I don't make these knots big. A lot of people don't use knots. I feel more secure having them. And they can be buried. Let me get this. So how many of you out there have gone and checked out the Twisted Crocheters? That's a good website for little animals that you can make for your children or even for adults. This is the one I'm making is actually for an adult. They're adorable. I put mine in the kitchen window. I think they're cute. So the next one I'll make is probably tan. I think that will look good. Light colored brown, and it would be easier for my eyes. And for an audience that's trying to watch this. So I'll just buried. Now let's secure this a little more. we got one more and we're done. We'll have to fix that eye, looks like. Yeah, my eyes kind of. One more arm. Look how adorable it is. I like to bend the arms. Looks like we're done. And there you go. There's your sloth. Hope you like it. Take care. Thank you for taking the time out to watch this long video with the sloth. It's all done. Hope you enjoyed it. If you like this video, there was part one and two, and this is the third to finish it up. Press like, subscribe, make a comment, let me know how I did, and we'll see you later. Bye-bye.